I'm Adam Steinfurth. This is the Prolific Oak Tree Google Sheets spreadsheet channel. And you've arrived at the right video if you know about the query function, but you're just not sure why you would use it instead of just using a pivot table. All right, so what we're going to do is go through several examples where we kind of know what end product we want, and we're going to create it with a pivot table, and then we're going to create it with a query, and we'll talk about the differences between the two. So first, let's do a basic pivot table, and we're going to average the prices of the items. So we will go to Insert, go down the pivot table, and the menu comes up asking us to create a pivot table. It wants to know where the data is. So after I clicked on that icon, it came up with some suggestions. So we're already seeing how a pivot table does make life easy, which is one of the advantages of it that you'll see over and over. And we will take the first selection because that's right, that guessed where my data is. And we'll say, let's put it on the existing sheet in G2. So we'll just type G2. Boom, so it puts in an empty pivot table. You're ready to build it. And we said we wanted items and average price. And pivot tables always default to sum, so you need to change that to average. Okay, this is what we want in the pivot table. But one more small adjustment here is that the query function doesn't return totals. So to do apples to apples, we'll just turn the totals off on the pivot table. They are really handy. So if you want those on there, that's something to keep in mind that the query function doesn't do. Well, we turn that off. And now we're going to create an equivalent output with the query function. We'll come over here. We will type query, opening parentheses, and it wants the data. So that will be this table over to the right. And already you can see a little difference because it's not making my life easier by guessing where it is. So I have to do the hard work of actually typing it in. So now that I typed in the data range, it wants the query. So this is where the query function goes off the rails because it is not like any other spreadsheet function within these quotes. So you need double quotes. It expects a SQL query. SQL is its own language, structured query language, and it is not like a spreadsheet function. So you have to learn that. So that's problem number one with query function. But we're going to use the language, and the thing that you always have to start with is a select clause, and that is telling the function what it's going to return. So we want it to return the item, which is in column B in the source data. So we can just type in B, and the average of column D, right? So we will say AVG, because that's one of the aggregation functions available of D. And then it needs to know what to group by. Whenever you use an aggregation function like average, you need the group by clause. So we will say group by, and we group to by item, right? So we'll say B. And we're almost done. We will hit a comma to go on to the third argument, which is optional, but we need it here because the first row is a header. So we will say one in that, hit enter. And now here we have it. We have the equivalent output to this pivot table using the query function. And I did this before, so it caught formatting that I'd already applied. But when you do it the first time, the formatting is going to look like this, which is what the output really is. Right, they didn't round it, and it doesn't make the assumption that it's currency. Assuming that you want that, we will add the format clause, so do space format. We're going to be formatting the average of D, and we'll have to do single quotes around this format because double quotes will surround this entire instruction set. Dollar sign, pound, pound, 0.00 will give us the formatting that we want. Click enter. And there we go. This formatting is completely contained within the query function. and you can change it if you need it. So the takeaways from this first example is that the query function can't do the totals like the pivot table could, but the pivot table can't control the formatting. All right, so one for one, right? Let's step this up a notch. Let's take this really small pivot table. We'll come down, we'll paste it below, and we're going to add another dimension to it. So we're going to get the average of the price, but we want it by shipping method. So in a pivot table, it's relatively intuitive. You probably need some practice first, but it's relatively intuitive to take the shipping method and put it in the columns. All right, and this is exactly what I wanted. So for whatever reason, aluminum is $23.46 on average if you ship it less than a truckload. But if you do truckload, it's $23.04. Who would have known? Let's do that with the query function. So we will take advantage of our previous work here. We will copy this, paste it here, and we're going to add a clause called pivot. So we'll come in here right before format. So there is an order that these clauses have to be in. And I would not describe the query function as being forgiving, so you have to get it right. We'll put it before format. I'll show you the order in a second. We'll say pivot C. There we go, pretty fast, right? It made a pivot table. Let's check if the numbers are reasonable. 2371, 2969. Yeah, that's still working. Let's make this pivot table equivalent by taking off the totals so it looks exactly the same. Now, I promised you to see the order that these need to be in. So we'll go to Sheets Help. We'll look at the query function. So select, you always have to start with that. But then we had a group by and a pivot, and we had them in that order. All right, let's go back. And let's say instead of average a price, we want to do a calculated field. We want to calculate the profit. So in order to do that in Sheets, if you'll notice, there is no column here with the value of profit. Profit would be price minus cost. So we will need to do a calculated field. So instead of price, let's come back over to the right. We will delete that. We don't need that anymore. And now for the value, we're going to do a calculated field, and we will do, well, for calculated fields, you need to see it. The graphical user interface kind of breaks down. It doesn't really serve you inside this field. We'll do price minus cost. Should calculate it for us. And I think that's the sum of the profit, but we'll leave it as that for now. That looks good. We can even control this header, we'll say profit. And now let's do that with the query function. And I really think it's a little bit more intuitive with the query function. If you want to see a video just on doing calculated fields, I'll link to that right now. I just made one a few weeks ago. Let's paste that query. This is what I've been trying to avoid. I need to paste the text of the query so it doesn't shift the source data down. Let me go back and do that again. All right, so we pasted the query, but we want to change the average price to profit. So let's come in here. So we want to replace the average of D with essentially, I'm having a hard time there, D minus E, but you need to do the sum of each. So the sum of D, so all the D's minus the sum of all the E's. That will be the sum of the profit like we did in the pivot table. And then we're still okay grouping by the item, which is B. But then we're going to, we have to change what we're saying we're formatting. So we need to change it to this little calculation. Copy and paste it over to here. We hit enter. And there, the exact same result. Calculated field in a pivot table and just doing some plain old math with the query function. Now you'll see the label got a little bit ugly by this point. So we need to add in the label clause. So we have select, group by, format. Let's see where label comes in. Select, group by, format. Label needs to be before format. So we will come back and put that in. Label. And what we're labeling is this calculated column value, and let's put it in single quotes and we'll call it profit. There we go. There's a nice custom label for you. Now we'll try another function of pivot tables that I know you can do in query, is to summarize by date. So in order to do that, we need to put the date field into the pivot table. So we'll take date and time. We'll make that the rows. But it looks ugly like that, right? What you need to do is right click on any of the times, and then we're going to create a pivot date group, and we'll say by month. There we go. This is a profit by month. Let's go back to average. So we'll take the price, plop it in there, change the summarize by to average. All right, now let's try to make the equivalent output with the query function. And what we want to do is add in the date, right? So we're going to say, we're going to add A to the select clause, but we're going to wrap it in a function called month. This is not the spreadsheet function called month, it's a SQL function called month. So we're going to turn A into a number for the month. Then we're going to return the item, then the average price, and we're going to group it by the month. So we'll say group it by month A. And then by item, just like the pivot table is. Let's hit enter. And there we go. This is the same table. You look at a few of these values and they line up. One quirk here is that the SQL language considers January to be the 0th month. That's not very handy, right? But for now, for the sake of illustration, query is able to output a pretty equivalent report. Now we're almost ready to talk about why you would use query, because so far we've shown what it can do, but it always seems a little bit harder, right? You have to be familiar with that different syntax. But let's talk about some things that the query function can do that pivot tables can't. So we'll come back down to the bottom of our data, and let's say we want to use data from a different file, a completely different file. So we will take this different spreadsheet, we'll put it on the right. We'll go back to our main spreadsheet and we'll put it on the left. Now, granted, I did just duplicate the file, so it looks exactly the same, but trust me, this is two separate spreadsheets. With the pivot table, the data has to be in the same spreadsheet, but with the query function, you can embed an import range. So let's do import range by itself. What the import range wants is this URL of the other spreadsheet. So let's grab this, copy that, plop it in to the function, and then it needs the range string. So let's say sheet one, A1 through, what is it, E101, right? If we hit enter, it has an error first. You have to allow access. A bit of a typo there. That's the way to do that range. Okay, so it brings the entire sheet in, but then we can wrap that in the query function. So let's grab this import range, put it on our clipboard by copying it, and let's come down and we'll write out the query function. And for the data, we're going to do a curly brace to tell Google Sheets to get ready for an array. First, we'll do that import range. Let's take the equal sign off of it. And now let's do a semicolon to join it to the table here, which I'll take the header row off of it. So we'll say A2 through A101. In that with the curly brace to say that the array is done. We'll do a basic query, and then we'll say one header. And it put together multiple ranges from different spreadsheets. And let's do one more thing. So this one is kind of playing around. I did it on this other sheet already. Because it's in a formula, query can be used in all sorts of different ways. So here I just created something silly where I said, if this checkbox here is equal to true, so if it's checked, do a query. If not, leave it blank. So you can just do this. Turn the query on and off. Now, if that's not useful, I don't know what is, but see this next video for a little bit more on the query function. I'll see you in that video. Thanks for watching.